Hello students, today we will start our class 10th chemistry chapter number 1, chemical reactions and equations. The first and the foremost thing, what is a chemical reaction? So a chemical reaction can be defined a combination of two chemical substances which results in the formation of a new chemical compound. So how we can predict the chemical reaction that is occurring or ongoing a process, or how we can say a chemical reaction is going on? So the chemical reaction can be identified by three ways. Either in the chemical reaction, there is the evolution of gases. We can see the evolution of gases, right? Different gases are evolved, and there are the tests to identify or to detect the type of gases that are evolved. The second thing is by the evolution of heat. So a reaction can be an exothermic reaction or an endothermic reaction. An exothermic reaction is that reaction in which the heat is evolved or heating is observed, while an endothermic reaction is that reaction in which heat is absorbed or cooling is observed. Suppose we are doing this reaction in a test tube. So in an exothermic reaction, the test tube will get heated up, while in endothermic reaction, the test tube will feel cool on touching that test tube. Now third is the by changing color. This is the most common and the easiest matter. Whenever a chemical reaction goes or proceed, there is a change in the color of the substance. The original color gets changed into and forms a different color. So now we will learn one by one how these tests are done. So first is the by evolution of gas. By evolution of gas, if till your level there is only two gases, carbon dioxide and hydrogen. So if we say about carbon dioxide is observed by, it will either turn lime water. Lime water is a solution of calcium hydroxide. It will turn lime water milky in color, means it lime water has a transparent look, but as soon as carbon dioxide is passed through this lime water, it will turn milky due to the formation of insoluble calcium carbonate. So this is the most used method to identify carbon dioxide gas which is evolved during a chemical reaction. Second thing is by brisk effervescence. By brisk effervescence means you have seen in the cold drink, the bubbles are coming out of the cold drink bottle. The bubbles are assembled together and they come out of the cold drink bottle. These bubbles together, the look is known as brisk effervescence. So whenever carbon dioxide comes out of the liquid, there is a formation of brisk effervescence. So you can identify a carbon dioxide coming out of the liquid by brisk effervescence. And third is the carbon dioxide does not support burning, right? So whenever you will bring a burning matchstick or a burning splinter near the mouth of the test tube, the burning splinter or the matchstick will get extinguished. So carbon dioxide is also identified by this method. Second gas is the hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas, whenever there is a formation of hydrogen is the only element which is having highest calorific value. So whenever hydrogen gas comes out, when we will, if you will bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of that test tube, it will burn with a pop-up sound. Pop-up sound means there are small hydrogen bombs which are creating this pop-up sound. Hydrogen burns with a high calorific value, so there is a pop-up sound. So two gases, carbon dioxide and hydrogen, both are odorless, colorless, and but can be identified by these three, these all methods, right? This thing you have to keep in your mind, because this identification of carbon dioxide gas and identification of hydrogen gas will play a major role in chapter carbon and its compound, right? Now second is by evolution of heat. As I told you earlier, chemical reaction proceed either by evolution of heat, that reaction is known as exothermic reaction, that test tube will get heated up, or it will proceed by absorption of heat, that is known as endothermic reaction. In this case, that test tube will feel cool on touching, it will feel cool. And last is that by changing color. You might have seen that whenever you see a chemistry lab in TV or anything, you will always find that there is a lot of chemicals, vapors coming out of the flask, and these are different colors in the chemical laboratory. So this is by change in color. This is the easiest way of identification of a chemical reaction. Now there are different types of reaction in a chemistry. So we will learn one reactions one by one. The first is the combination reaction. Combination reaction means, as the name suggests, there is a combination of two elements. Suppose element A combines with element B and forms element C, right? So two elements combine to form a element, third compound, that is we can say C, right? So you can see in the example, hydrogen is combining with oxygen. This 2 is written as 2 moles of hydrogen, and there is nothing written, that means 1. So 2 moles of hydrogen reacts with 1 moles of oxygen to give 2 moles of water molecule, that is in the liquid state. This gas and liquid, this is states are written in each case. In the second case, you can see 2 moles of magnesium reacts with 1 moles of oxygen to form 2 mole of magnesium oxide. This is a very important reaction in terms of your board exams, because this is asked frequently, means many times it has been asked, that a magnesium ribbon, magnesium element is in the form of ribbon. It when it is burnt in the presence of oxygen, it burns with a bright dazzling light, means the light that you see in the sparkle during Diwali times. So it burns with a white sparkle light, sparkling dazzling white light, and is a formation of white powdery substance known as magnesium oxide. So many times this question has been asked, what happens when magnesium react with oxygen? So it forms magnesium oxide, right? So this is combination reaction, very easy. A plus B, that will be giving C. So this is combination reaction. Second is decomposition reaction. Again, this PbNO3, lead nitrate, this is lead nitrate. This lead nitrate is in the form of powder, solid is written. When it is heated, it decomposes. Decomposition is just opposite of combination. Whatever had been combined, it get decomposed on being heating. So on being on thermal decomposition, it forms lead oxide, and with the evolution of reddish brown color gas, that is nitrogen dioxide. This reaction has also been asked many times in board exam. Nitrogen dioxide, that is reddish brown gas, and this reddish brown is then from this statement we can identify that the question is of lead nitrate. All right, so learn this reaction. This is a very important reaction given in the NCRT, also in the NCRT. Next reaction, PbBr2, that is lead bromide electrolytic decomposition. There are many types of decomposition. This is thermal decomposition, that means in the presence of heat. This is electrolytic decomposition, that means in the presence of electricity. So it forms lead plus bromine. This is very important reaction also, lead bromide or lead chloride, PbCl2, is also a very important reaction. So these are two reactions, combination, and the opposite is decomposition reaction. Now, again, exothermic reaction. See, you can see the combination reactions, mostly combination reactions, carbon plus oxygen. In this case, heat is evolved. The reaction will be written like this. Heat is evolved, and this is an example of exothermic reaction. You can see heat is absorbed in this, heat is absorbed. For this reaction, heat is supplied. Means if you will combine nitrogen with oxygen, you have to heat the content, then there will be the formation of nitrogen oxide. And in this case, cooling will be observed. So this is an example of endothermic reaction. You can also see these things in NCRT written very clearly. Now this is next type of reaction is substitution displacement, and very important reaction from board point of view, displacement reaction or substitution reaction. In this reaction, a highly reactive substance will displace a low reactive substance. This will be clear from example. Suppose you are sitting in a train on a seat, right? And a bodybuilder type person comes. And he will lift you from the seat and will sit itself there, right? So because he has more power than you, so it will displace you. In the same way, in this reaction, a highly reactive element will displace a low reactive element. In this case, copper is low reactive and iron is more reactive. So iron will displace copper from its solution, and this will form iron 2 sulfate and will form copper reddish brown substance. Copper solid will be formed. This reaction is very important reaction from board point of view. And how you one question might be in your mind, that how we can know that which element is more reactive or which one is less reactive. So this You will learn from reactivity series that we will see in next chapter, the reactivity series. In second example, you can see magnesium is in the solid form, but it will displace hydrogen and will form magnesium sulfate plus hydrogen. So reactivity series I will tell you afterward. Till now you understand only this, that in a displacement reaction a highly reactive substance will displace a low reactive substance. Fine. Now double displacement reaction, this double displacement reaction, this one has been asked many times in board exam because it is also an example of precipitation reaction. See, you can see in double displacement, in displacement reaction only one element is changing its place. You can see copper and iron, they are changing their place. Copper is displacing iron, displacing copper, and only copper and iron are changing their place. But in double displacement reaction, two elements simultaneously change their place. You can see sodium will displace silver, and both will change their place together. Silver will come with chlorine and sodium will go with nitrite. So they will form sodium nitrate and silver chloride. So this is double displacement. In this case, two displacement occur together. You can see this is a very famous example in which barium chloride reacts with sulfuric acid. This is sulfuric acid. Barium chloride reacts with sulfuric acid, and barium will displace hydrogen and will form barium sulfate BaSO4 and 2 moles of this hydrochloric acid, 2 moles of hydrochloric acid HCl, right? So the, and this BaSO4 is in the form of precipitate. Precipitate means, suppose you add sand in water, the sand will settle down in the form of precipitate. So precipitate is something which is soluble in anything, but after addition of something it becomes insoluble and will settle down in the solution. That is known as precipitate. So barium precipitate, barium sulfate forms a precipitate, and it is also an example of precipitation reaction, right? So learn this barium sulfate example, because it is also very important from the board point of view. Now the last reaction is oxidation reduction reaction. Oxidation reduction, or we can say it redox reaction. Red means reduction and ox means oxidation. So this is also known by the name redox reaction, because in this case oxidation and reduction both are occurring simultaneously. You can see what is oxidation. Oxidation is addition of oxygen. Suppose if we see the example of magnesium, in this there is addition of oxygen in magnesium, so magnesium is getting oxidized. So this is oxidation, and oxidation is also known by removal of hydrogen. If in an element we are adding oxygen, then it is oxidation, and if you are removing hydrogen, then also it is oxidation. The opposite is reduction. In reduction, suppose we are removing oxygen, so that is reduction, or we are adding hydrogen, so that is also reduction. So you learn one thing, either oxidation or reduction, and the opposite is will be the other one, right? You can see this example, CuO copper oxide plus carbon monoxide. On reaction, this CuO will become CO2, means this oxygen is getting combining with CuO and will forming carbon dioxide, and this oxygen is removed and CuO will become in the solid form alone. So reduction is of copper oxide because oxygen is being removed, and oxidation will be of carbon monoxide because oxygen is added in this, and there is a formation of CO2. So this is oxidation reduction reaction or redox reaction. Learn this, focus on NCERT, learn chapter 1 means you will get problem, then ask me in the message, I will reply you. Whatever problem you will have, I will reply you, I will clear the doubts. So please learn all these things in this holidays and prepare this chapter 1. This is a very easy chapter, only you have to focus on some topics. Important is double displacement reaction, this oxidation reaction and displacement reaction, then thermal that decomposition reaction example, right? And don't forget to press the bell icon and subscribe my channel. Thank you. We will now meet in next class. Thank you.